Solved problems on power series and a summary of the theory. Power series are an extraordinary tool to consider somewhat complicated functions. For example, we will see in a moment that power series allow us to express the value of the integral from 0 to 0.4 of natural logarithm of x to the fourth plus 1 dx in terms of a converging alternating series. A power series centered at a number c is a series of the type px equals a0 plus a1 times x minus c plus a2 times x minus c squared plus and so forth. Using the summation symbol, this becomes summation k from 0 to the infinity ak times x minus c to the power k. This is a power series because the kth term involves the kth power of x minus c. If c is 0, then the power series is a simpler one. It is just a0 plus a1x plus a2x squared plus and so forth, summation k from 0 to the infinity ak times x to the power k. A number r is called the radius of convergence of the power series px equals a0 plus a1x minus c plus and so forth, summation k from 0 to the infinity ak x minus c to the power k. If the series converges for x minus c of absolute value less than r and diverges when the absolute value of x minus c is greater than r. This is the radius of convergence of a power series. All power series do have a radius of convergence, which may be 0 or may be the infinity. If the radius of convergence is 0, then the power series converges only at the point C. If the radius of convergence is the infinity, the power series converges for all values of x. For a power series, summation k from 0 to the infinity ak x minus c to the power k, one can compute the radius of convergence with the ratio test if the limit of absolute value of ak divided by absolute value of ak plus 1 as k goes to the infinity exists. So from the ratio test it follows that the radius of convergence is this limit. From the root test it follows that the radius of convergence is the limit of the absolute value of ak raised to the power negative 1 over k and k goes to the infinity. These formulas can be applied only if these limits exist naturally. It may very well happen that these limits do not exist. That is typically the case if every second coefficient in this power series is zero, then these limits do not exist, or even these quantities are not always defined. And in that case, the radius of convergence has to be determined by other means. The geometric series is a basic power series. The summation formula for the geometric series tells us that 1 plus x squared plus and so forth equals 1 divided by 1 minus x, assuming that the absolute value of x is less than 1. That is, the power series summation k from 0 to the infinity x to the power k converges if the absolute value of x is less than 1, and in that case its sum is 1 divided by 1 minus x. This is a basic power series which can be used to derive power series representations for many functions. That can be done by differentiating or integrating this series, and when this series converges, this differentiation or integration can be done term by term. This is a powerful method to find power series representing given functions. The radius of convergence of the power series summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x to the power k is r. Our task is to find the radius of convergence of the power series summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x to the power 2k. Observe first that every second coefficient of this power series summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x to the power 2k is 0. That is, if we would like to apply the formula given by the ratio and root test for the radius of convergence, the formula says that the radius of convergence is limit as k goes to the infinity, absolute value of ak divided by the absolute value of ak plus 1, or limit as k goes to the infinity of the absolute value of ak raised to the power negative 1 over k. If we were to apply this formula, then a2k would be bk for all k, and every a2k plus 1, every odd coefficient would be 0. Therefore, the quantities absolute value of ak divided by absolute value of ak plus 1 are not defined always, because every second denominator becomes 0. The same applies to the quantities absolute value of ak raised to the power negative 1 over k. Every second such quantity would be an expression where the denominator is 0, hence it is undefined. Therefore, these formulas cannot be used in this case. We must think of something else. So, we have to find a number r prime such that the power series summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x to the power 2k converges if the absolute value of x is less than r prime and diverges if the absolute value of x is greater than r prime. If we find such a number r prime, then we have found the radius of convergence by the definition of this concept. So consider again the original series px summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x to the power k. This converges if absolute value of x is less than r and diverges if absolute value of x is greater than r, because r is the radius of convergence of this series. The power series summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x to the power 2k can be written as summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x squared raised to the power k. X to the 2k is same as x squared raised to the power k. So this power series is simply the original power series evaluated at x squared. So this converges if the absolute value of x squared is less than r. So it converges if the absolute value of x raised to the power 2 is less than r. And this means that the power series summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x to the power 2k converges if the absolute value of x is less than square root of r. R prime is the radius of convergence of the power series summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x to the power 2k. R prime has the property that the power series converges whenever absolute value of x is less than r prime. Now, from the fact that it converges whenever absolute value of x is less than square root of r, it follows that r prime is greater than or equal to square root of r. Likewise, the original series diverges if the absolute value of x is greater than r. So this power series summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x to the power 2k, which is the original series evaluated at x squared, diverges if absolute value of x squared is greater than r. And this means that the series summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x to the power 2k diverges if the absolute value of x is greater than square root of r. And this, on the other hand, implies that r prime is at most square root of r. So we have now seen that r prime is at most square root of r and at least square root of r. So we conclude that r prime is square root of r. The answer is that the radius of convergence of the power series summation k from 1 to the infinity bk x raised to the power 2k is square root of r. In this problem, our task is to approximate the integral from 0 to 0.4 of ln of x to the fourth plus 1 dx with error less than 0.001. This can rather easily be done with power series as it turns out. We first look at the function f of x equals ln x to the fourth plus 1. We would like to find a power series expansion for this particular function. We start by observing that its derivative is 4x cubed divided by 1 plus x to the fourth. This derivative is the sum of a geometric series. It's the sum of a geometric series whose first term is 4 times x cubed and whose ratio of two subsequent terms is negative x to the fourth. So this is the series 4x cubed minus 4 times x to the seventh plus 4 times x to the power 11 minus and so forth. That is summation k from 0 to the infinity 4 times x cubed times negative x to the fourth raised to the power k. And this can be written as summation k from 0 to the infinity negative 1 raised to the power k 4 times x raised to the power 3 plus 4k. We observe that this series converges if the absolute value of x to the fourth is less than 1. That is, if the absolute value of x is less than 1. And therefore, this series representation for the derivative of the function ln of x to the fourth plus 1 certainly converges on the whole interval of integration from 0 to 0.4 and also at the endpoints of this interval. So we have f prime of x equals summation k from 0 to the infinity negative 1 raised to the power k 4 times x raised to the power 3 plus 4k. The function is an antiderivative of its derivative. Therefore, f of x is of the form integral of summation k from 0 to the infinity negative 1 raised to the power k 4 times x raised to the power 3 plus 4k dx plus a constant of integration. We do not know what this constant of integration is, but for some constant of integration c, for some c, f of x must be integral of summation k from 0 to the infinity negative 1 raised to the power k 4 times x raised to the power 3 plus 4k dx plus c. So this means that f of x is c plus summation k from 0 to the infinity integral of negative 1 raised to the power k 4 times x raised to the power 3 plus 4k dx. Here we have switched summation and integration. It can be done if the power series converges on a closed interval. Now we are looking at the closed interval from 0 to 0.4, and it certainly converges on that interval and also at its endpoints. So we can do this switching. F of x then is c plus summation k from 0 to the infinity integral of negative 1 raised to the power k 4 times x raised to the power 3 plus 4k dx. And these integrals in the sum are easy to compute. We get f of x equals c plus summation k from 0 to the infinity negative 1 raised to the power k 4 times x raised to the power 4 plus 4k and that divided by 4 plus 4k. We observe that this simplifies, the 4s cancel out and they become just 1s. And therefore we have that for the function f of x equals ln of x to the fourth plus 1, we have the representation, it is c plus summation k from 0 to the infinity, negative 1 raised to the power k, x to the power 4 plus 4k divided by 1 plus k. We substitute x equals 0 to get that if 0, which is ln of 1, which is ln of 0 to the fourth plus 1, this must be c plus summation k from 0 to the infinity, negative 1 raised to the power k, 0 raised to the power 4 plus 4k divided by 1 plus k. In this sum, every term is 0, therefore we have an equation 0 equals c plus 0, and c is therefore 0. So we have found out that f of x is summation k from 0 to the infinity, negative 1 raised to the power k, x to the power 4 plus 4k divided by 1 plus k. So we have found the representation ln of x to the fourth plus 1 is summation k from 0 to the infinity and 1 raised to the power k, x to the power 4 plus 4k divided by 1 plus k. This series is valid for all x whose absolute value is less than 1. We plug this power series in this integral. So integral from 0 to 0.4 ln of x to the power 4 plus 1 dx becomes integral from 0 to 0.4 of the sum summation k from 0 to the infinity, negative 1 raised to the power k, x to the power 4 plus 4k divided by 1 plus k dx. Now we have an integral of a sum. This is same as sum of the integrals. So this can be written as summation k from 0 to the infinity, integral from 0 to 0.4, negative 1 raised to the power k, x to the power 4 plus 4k divided by 1 plus k. Here it is important that the series representation for the function ln of x to the 4th plus 1 converges on the whole closed interval from 0 to 0.4. If that is the case, as it is here, we can switch integration and summation. So we have found the representation integral from 0 to 0.4 ln of x to the 4th plus 1 dx is sum k from 0 to the infinity integral from 0 to 0.4 of negative 1 raised to the power k x to the power 4 plus 4k divided by 1 plus k dx. Its integral is easy to compute. So this becomes summation k from 0 to the infinity substitution from 0 to 0.4 to the expression negative 1 raised to the power k x to the power 4 plus 4k plus 1, which is x to the power 5 plus 4k, divided by 5 plus 4k times 1 plus k. And we substitute from 0 to 0.4. Substitution to the lower limit gives 0. Substitution to the upper limit gives that this integral is sum k from 0 to the infinity, negative 1 raised to the power k, 0.4 raised to the power 5 plus 4k, and that divided by 5 plus 4k, and that sum multiplied by 1 plus k. So here we have a series representation for this integral. We had to approximate the integral from 0 to 0.4 of ln of x to the 4th plus 1 dx with error less than 0.001. Now this problem becomes approximate the sum of the series summation k from 0 to the infinity, negative 1 raised to the power k, 0.4 raised to the power 5 plus 4k, and that divided by 5 plus 4k times 1 plus k. This series converges by the alternating series test. This is immediate. Therefore, we may use the alternating series test also to figure out how many terms of this series we need to take to get the desired accuracy for the sum of this series. So these terms of this alternating series, the AKs, they are 0.4 to the power 5 plus 4k divided by 5 plus 4k times 1 plus k. Let us just compute first few values. So we form a table. If k is 1, then ak can be computed by a calculator or computer. We get that it is approximately 0.002048. And if k is 1, ak is approximately 0.000015. This is already less than 0.001. Therefore, we get the desired accuracy by the alternating series test, simply by taking the first term of this power series for this integral. So the answer is that integral from 0 to 0.4 ln of x to the power 4 plus 1 dx is approximately 0.4 raised to the power 5, and that divided by 5, which is approximately 0.002048. And this has the desired accuracy. The last two decimals, 4 and 8, are not anymore correct, but 2 is correct, and this is the answer to this problem. So here you see the power series were really quite powerful tool indeed.